Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to be walking through how we can make a language translation worksheet in Google Sheets. This is going to be helpful whether you're learning a new language or teaching someone else a new language. This worksheet will have a word or sentence that we wish for our student to translate. In the second field, the student will enter the translation of the word. Then, in the last column, we will tell the student automatically whether the answer they provided was correct or not. To begin, let's first enter our column titles. We will enter our initial language, so for me, that'll be English, our translation language, French, and our validation column. Obviously, the languages that you wish to translate between can be any two languages. I will be walking through an English to French example, but I will show you how you can use any other two languages as we prepare the worksheet. Let's firstly go through and enter some words or phrases, both work, into our primary language column. So I'll just enter some common words and a phrase. Then in our second column, we will just leave it empty for now, as this is where our students will provide their answers. Now let's work on creating a validation system that will tell our students right away whether they provided the correct answer or not. To do this, let's go to our first entry here and click. Then let's call our if function. The if function will take a logical expression, meaning we can use it to compare one value to another, and print one answer if the two values are equal, and another if they are different. To do this, we will check if our student's answer is equal to the translated word or phrase, which we can simply use the Google Translate function to check against. To do this, we simply type Google Translate to call the function. This function expects three values. Firstly, we'll enter the word or phrase that we want translated. So, our first column's value, and then we'll add a comma. Then we enter the language that we are giving the function. So for me, this is going to be English. Therefore, in commas, I will add en, like so. All the languages are given a shorthand like this. If you're unsure what the shorthand for the language is that you want to translate, I will leave a link to Google's language codes down below in the description. Then we need to tell our function what language we want to translate into. Therefore, since I want to translate into French, I will put FR like so. If you were translating from English to another language, you would go to that language code link in the description down below, find the language that you wish to translate into, and place that here instead of French. Now, this section will give our function a simple true or false, depending if these two values are equal or not. If they are equal, we can provide an output to our students, telling them that they are correct, like so. Then add another comma, and it allows to do the same, assuming that the two values are not equal. Now that our validation element is completed, we can drag this down like so, as that'll extend the provided formula to the remainder of the rows in this column. And that is it. Let's begin by filling out some of these French words to ensure that our system works. Door in French is port, and as we can see, this is correct. However, if we enter the incorrect word for wood, we get an incorrect try again. And that's it. We have now just created a preliminary word translation worksheet in Google Sheets that'll help us translate between two languages. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how to create a language translation sheet in Google Sheets. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, or consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.